Tide report from FWC. Most of Lee and Collier counties are looking relatively clean and clear of the bacteria. But look at Charlotte County. These red dots really jump out to you. Those red dots mean high concentrations of red tide all over Charlotte Harbor.
And this is what happens when you have high concentrations of dead fish. Look at belly up in Charlotte Harbor. The harbor has been riddled with red tide for the last 3 weeks. People who spend a lot of time on the water say this is a very bad sign.
I'm going to pray and hope that I'm wrong, but I have a feeling this summer is going to be not a good one. You know, I hope I'm wrong.
NBC2's Michael Raimondi talked to the experts about why Charlotte County just can't seem to shake its red tide sickness.
Pretty nasty up here in the mouth of the river, for sure.
Captain Josh Greer has navigated these waters for nearly 15 years.
You know, I spent my whole life outside.
Today, he's showing me around.
It's going to be somewhere.
He's guiding us around Charlotte Harbor. This is the best condition he's seen the water in for weeks.
You can smell it. You can, you know, feel it in your throat.
We start by checking smaller canals for red tide.
When I first heard it, I didn't want to believe it.
Thankfully, no sign of it. But upriver near the I-75 bridge, we found a trace of it. FWC is testing the water here. They found medium to high concentrations of red tide the past couple weeks. Greer thinks the dry weather has the Peace River flowing weaker than normal. It's not pushing nutrients out to the Gulf.
We are concerned about a potential super bloom this summer because the red tide is sticking around.
James Evans says a lack of fresh water here could be the problem. There are too many factors to predict where it could go next.
Fingers crossed that we won't see a super bloom. But we're pretty concerned and we're watching it very closely.
For Captain Greer,
it's not rocket science. It's pretty easy.
He wants the state to crack down on nutrient overload in our water.
How many times can it do that before it doesn't come back again? We need to be more proactive and let's stop these things before they happen.
We'll let you know if this bloom starts shifting to other areas. Reporting in Charlotte Harbor, Michael Raimondi, NBC.